Hey guys, welcome to Vidovic Arts. I'm Josh, and today we're making some kitbashed Deathkorps of Krieg. Now, you may have noticed there's something a little different about myself in the context of I am 3D. That's right, I have gone and made a 3D digital avatar for some streams over on Twitch, and this video itself was actually done over on Twitch, where I created the entire kitbash over there, and I talked to you guys, and we went through things. I pretty much made it like a normal video, but I could actually respond to any questions that you guys had. It was a lot of fun, and I would like to do it a lot more, and hopefully you guys enjoyed it, because I intend to be doing a lot more stream-based things in the future, where you can interact with me in this beautiful little Matrix-like environment. You'll be able to throw things at me and do a whole bunch of stuff. So, yeah. I've also got, like, sort of want to talk to people and interview them. So, yeah. There's some stuff coming in the future, as well as just general gameplay of random games. But let's get straight into this video right now. Hopefully, this works nice and neat. Yes, it does. You can see my hands right here on the table. That's right in front of me. That's 100% my digital hands in real life. So we're making some Deathkorps of Krieg. Now I'm going to show you what I've made previously, just to sort of show you what exactly we're looking at in the end product here. So if you're not familiar with Deathkorps of Krieg, they're basically World War I Germans that have somehow managed to continue their fighting style in the 41st millennium. It makes no sense at all, but like, it's cool. That's all that matters. It's the rule of cool. So these guys are more or less World War I Germans with a futuristic kind of set to them. So you can see here, they're kind of like straight up. None of these are official Warhammer models, just so you know. They're all kitbashed. Some of them are 3D printed, some of them are 3D printed, and some of them have 3D printed bits, and some of them have other bits that are attached from official models. So I'll explain them as we go. So I'm going to use this knife as my pointer. You can see here that this is basically an Imperial Guard las gun, and I can tell you now that this guy is maybe like 90% of him Imperial Guardsman. So his legs underneath are Imperial Guard legs, his arms, his body and all that stuff, all Imperial Guard, even the rifle. I didn't even bother changing the rifle at all. But the head is actual Deathkorps of Krieg. If I can get real close, I have set up a very specific camera here just to be able to do this. All right, so if you can see there, it is a Deathkorps of Krieg helmet. Now that is not 3D printed, and it is not the official Deathkorps of Krieg. It is the official, but it's not the official Deathkorps of Krieg helmet. So I'll explain how that happened as we go on. Now the backpack is 3D printed. The grenade is from a separate kit, and this is just, you know, straight something from your Imperial Guardsman kit. So you can see most of him is Imperial Guard. There's a couple bits and bobs that aren't. The cape is sculpted, so you can just see the cape that goes around, and I got like a bit of, it looks like poo on here, but that is like a muddy wash that's deliberately disgusting. It was kind of a test, I think. But yeah, you can see he's come through pretty clean. Now that's one of my key examples, because he's an Imperial Guardsman that you can totally make with very little effort. I like them quite a lot. Now this one that I'm going to show you next has been shown before on YouTube. I've seen a video of someone kitbashing their own thing, but the way I've done it isn't the way they did it. They used two separate kits, whereas this is just one. So this is straight up a World War I 28mm guy. So you can see he's got the World War I gas mask. He's still got the same rifle. I didn't bother editing that at all. I did add some shoulder pads and the little cape around the side, which was a real pain in the backside to do, but it's not too big a deal once you get into it. And the backpack as well is actually the same case as that helmet. So that is the official backpack, but it's not the official backpack. And again, I will explain exactly what I'm on about with these once we get into it. So there's three different versions of Deathkorps. So that was the first one, which is the Imperial Guard. The second one, which is the World War One guy. And this one, which is almost, this is entirely 3D printed. So this is a model that I've recently released on Patreon, which will be coming out on Cults very soon. You can see here, it's all 3D printed. Actually, I'm lying. This part isn't 3D printed. It's the same sort of backpack as the other one. Now, I've gone and kitbashed a whole bunch of different dudes here. So they're all using their own little differences between each other. But you can see here, this is actually, if you can see under here, you can sort of see those layer lines. That's where the 3D printedness is. But this is a multi 3D print part. So I'm using different 3D printers for this. For the legs and the, I think it's just the legs. That's FDM. The top is resin. The arms are also resin. And this part is a secret. So they're the three types of guys that I have. Now, the fourth one, which is what I'm working on today to show you, is something a little different. Something I'm a little proud of. I kind of like them quite a lot. I haven't actually painted them up to look all nice, but I have a box of them here. So I'm going to show you what we're going to be working on today. It's not crazy, like, a lot of effort, because I think making the capes on these guys is probably the longest amount of time, because it's just a pain, because you have to lay out a little thing and then cut it up and then wrap it around him. And then, these guys, the kits that they come with already have, use my little pointer, they already have their capes, and they look bloody awesome. You can see here, cape, and I've just dropped him. He's got good cape. I say cape, but it's like, you know, trench coat. You can see it looks really nice. But for the head, again, that is an official Deathkorps head. That's pretty much it. So Deathkorps head and official. Oh, no, that's 3D printed, that one. Okay, so it's pretty crazy. And the rifles, I haven't bothered changing them because I actually really like the muskets, or not even the muskets, just those bolt action, really long guns with really big bayonets. I actually really like that. You can see the difference, like, just between these two rifles here. This is just a stick, and this has, you can see a lot more detail in the 40k official rifles. And with my 3D print, you can see, like, you could squeeze a lot more kind of stuff in there compared to what this thing comes from. But if you really wanted to, you could just chop it off here and then add your own gun to the top, no issue. There's quite a lot of options that are, like, I'll show you the whole box here. So, you can see, I've gone, and I actually like them holding their rifles up. This is a World War One gas mask, and you can see all these different kits being bashed together. And this is 3D printed arms, so the different gun, and then there's multiple kits. You can actually see that he's got that green underneath there. Well, these sculpts here on the long coats are actually the model. So none of these have been sculpted, but these ones over here are sculpted. So you can see how it's curved. Basically, I used this knife, pretty much, and I just sculpted it up and like pinned it in like that, and then let it set. Now, let me show you the key thing that I've needed to do to make all of these possible, because I can't do anything without heads, and you don't need a 3D printer for this. This is one of the big shazams here, because I've been using 3D printers a lot in general. That's kind of my thing. So these guys, you don't technically need 3D printers at all if you don't want to. I can show you. I've got my little box, my little crate right here, and a couple examples of what I have done. So this stuff here, this stuff right here, this is what you'll need. It's a bit of fluff. This kind of gets a lot of hair stuck to it, because it's got like a bit of a, it's just got a bit of a sticky surface once it's done. So it's a two-part, no, it's not a two-part thing at all. It's a single part, it's kind of like silicon. You heat it up in boiling water, and you take it out, and you can sculpt it for a short while, and it goes hard, but it has a bit of a flexibility, so I can squeeze it like this, and it retains its shape. Now, this is an actual Deathkorps of Krieg head in there. So I sculpted around that, and inside was a Deathkorps of Krieg head. And once this set for a while, I popped it out, and I made another one, and made another one. So then all I have to do is put in some resin or whatever. I use this really beautiful stuff. Now, this is the two-part mixture, and I've used it a bunch on my channel, if you haven't seen it before. This is still the same one. So I bought this big tub, and it's lasted maybe 3 years, 3 or 4 years, and it's still going. So I just make a tiny bit of that, or you can use green stuff, and you shove it in there, and then once that sets, so it sets in around 3 hours, that's about on average, 3 to 4 hours, you end up with not this entire box, but these. And you can see that's a Deathkorps of Krieg head. So 3D printing does have a bit of a stigma, whether or not it is like stealing from Games Workshop or anyone that you're 3D printing. You could be 3D printing D&D models or whatever. I don't think it's stealing at all, because you know, you're creating a model, you want that model, whatever it is. It's a little different. It's not exactly what any of these companies are making. It's your own little thing that you're using. Now, I like the idea of kitbashing. I'm a massive, massive fan of kitbashing, and I think 3D printing should be a part of that. Not just, hey, let's 3D print everything, but more so, hey, let's 3D print parts and use it on other stuff. So I'm a huge fan of, you know, kitbashing your own guys, as you can see right here. But you know, it's up to you on your morality. If you don't like casting anything, you don't need to. You could 3D print pieces like this, but I wanted these specifically just to see how they would go, and they work pretty well. You can see, where's another one? This is actually one. Get up right close. You can see that I added like a little offcut to make it look like it's the gas mask end, and like it looks cool, and it's not too crazy, because you could end up doing the same thing with these guys. You could end up molding these helmets if you like them, or you could mold whatever the hell you want and work with them. Now, the reason why I'm showing this is because I've got a bunch of heads that I've been preparing, and I want to use on a couple models to make these guys. And they're really super simple. The hardest part, honestly, is these shoulder pads. So that's the only part that we're actually going to be, like, sculpting. And everything else is pre-made. But, again, you need this little fancy doodad. Now, I do have another unit here, which I'm just going to glance over. And they are the Death Riders. Now, these guys are so expensive. They are so stupidly expensive through the official means of getting them that this is honestly the only way you should do it. I do not think that they are worth as much as they cost on the official website. I don't understand why they're still as expensive as they are. So I went out and made my own, because I'm not going to spend that kind of money on a horse and a guy from World War I riding it. Now, the other ones, the official ones do have, like, explosive tips. The horse doesn't have tail, and it's got, like, talons instead of hooves. But I like the look of this old-school World War, just a horse. So the horse is actually from, it's like a knight kit. You can see here, I even attached the sword because I thought it'd be cool. Like, I just picture this dude going into battle and then having to pull out a sword because he's used his lance. But these horses, I think they cost, I'm going to spitball here, I think it was $48 AU, which is Australian, for 15 of them, or 12 or 15 of them. So it's a good kit. It's a good kit. But I can tell you right now, this other kit, which is mind-blowing, these guys here, which are still on Sprue, and these are the guys that we're fiddling with today. These guys, you can see this Sprue here. You've got, how many guys here? You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you're like, oh, okay, that's enough for one Sprue. But no, then you go down and there's even more. There's 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 guys on one Sprue. I shit you not. And I bought this for, I think, $25 on eBay. And that was including postage. And I'm like, this is too cheap. That's what they're actually called, the French Imperial Guard. And you can see right here, this trench coat, see how it folds up like that? That's exactly what we want. But, you know, if you don't really care, got down coats as well, which just, they look just as good, honestly. They look just as good. Now, the one downside to these models is that they are true scale. So true scale basically means they're closer to reality than Warhammer is, or most like tabletop 28mm stuff. So most of these dudes will have bigger hands. This is a 3D printed one. So he's got bigger hands, bigger head. He's got chunkier legs and all that kind of stuff. All these portions are a little bit bigger, but these dudes, which I can't actually put next to each other, let me see if I can get one and put it next to each other. So you can see just the portions, proportions wise, they're a little different. But when you've got, I don't know, 100 of them on the battlefield, which I intend to do, I want to have over 100 guys in trenches and all that kind of stuff. I don't really care. I think the idea is that they're so young. They're basically clones that are, you know, kids. They get sent out onto the battlefield. They're going to be pretty skinny, I guess. That's my opinion. My dudes are skinny. The ones that are a little chunkier have, you know, been on the battlefield a little longer. That's basically it. So, up to you whether or not you want to do this for yourself. But I think it's an awesome idea to save some money and, you know, have some really cool looking models. Now, again, I said, if you don't have an official Deathkorps of Krieg helmet and you can't replicate it, you can just 3D print something. Or you can use these. So, although this will cost a little bit extra. So, using these helmets from another kit and slapping them on there. But that'll cost you, like, for just that kit alone, it'll cost the same as the other kit. So, you know, you're spending another $30 just for helmets. There's no point spending that kind of money. This guy is probably one of my favorites, just because I love the idea. Just picturing him in the trenches, just playing his war drums. Got no guns at all. He doesn't even have like a grenade or a melee weapon. Is that? No, that's just nothing. It's his coat. So he's just playing away on his drums. Isn't that like, that's a cool idea? Having some Deathkorps of Krieg like band members. I like it. Alright, so we want to keep these heads. So we want to start cutting these out. Now, I don't have clippers, so I'm just going to use my knife. I'll just make a couple of these guys. Well, we want one with the coat open. See how this looks. Alright. So we are just going to do three dudes, just for the sake of time. And I'll just plop them down like this. Now these sculpts, you can probably see with this one, more so than the others, the mold lines are pretty noticeable. They're actually kind of really dodgy. And this kind of makes the argument of, oh yeah, no, Warhammer's expensive because of, you know, the molds. They're worth more. This one particular point might be valid for this. But in all honesty, it's not too hard to just clean it up. They are cheaper models, like cheaper than your average, well, they're cheaper than 40k, that's for sure. You can see not too much work really involved. And you can see he's nice. They've all got their own little issues. Might just want to go through one by one. Now, we have heads up in this corner. We only need three. Just going to grab three heads. One, two, and three. I'll put this up here. So we've already got some heads for these guys, and that's fine. Now, we do have some options on this sprue for guns. And they are plentiful. We could, you know, choose whatever we want here. Or we can look into some of the other kits that I have here. And these are all mostly, like, 3D printed. So it's all completely done. It's all completely doable if you have a 3D printer. But if you want to, you can totally use everything here. I can't show the full screen here. But I have just loads and loads of stuff. Each column is kind of... This is all for my Imperial Guard dudes that I'm working on. So I've got guns and just spare stuff that I've been building up. A whole bunch of legs. These are filament, which is completely fine. You can print all of this in filament, or you can print it in resin, whatever you want. One of the things that we're actually going to need is backpacks. So here's one. Now this is really silly. This one is 3D printed. And then I'm like, oh, I don't have access to my printer, so I'm just gonna duplicate it. So that's a 3D print of one of my own. This is the official one that I've also duplicated. And if we can score another backpack, maybe. Here we go. That is 3D printed, kind of obvious. So we've got three backpacks. One, two, three. Each of them have a backpack. I have guns. Now this is actually from a long, long time ago. I've printed up this one. This is back when I was doing the Space Marines. Just basically been collecting them, collecting failed prints. This one you can see is an actual failed print. That's a hand holding a rifle. Totally usable though. So you don't throw it away. You can still use it. Even these, like I've got like the barrels of guns. This was a completely failed print. But I'm like, you know what? I could probably use that. Even if it was just for terrain, like it was just a box or just a barrel sticking out of somewhere. Absolutely hoard everything. that's the secret to kit bashing. Keep everything. Don't throw anything away. Grab three bases though. Bits, bits, bits. I've seen some guns down here that I kind of like. I do like that they come already holding the gun upright, because that would be a real pain. There we go. So now I've got that unarmed hand and that gun. And we will use that knife with this guy here. And we've got a head and a backpack. So he's ready to go. That's one guy ready to go. Okay, so I got these over here. Now the thing I'm going to be gluing all these together is this super cheap ass super glue. If this screws up now, I'm not going to be happy. So I got super glue, rolling up my sleeves. You can see me rolling up my sleeves. Actually, one thing I noticed with these bases is that they're about the right height. So these are about the right height for 40k, but because when I add these to the top, they get a little taller, and I don't really like that. So what I'm going to do is swap these bases out for these ones. And you're probably like, what, they look identical. They are almost identical. From the top, you can't really tell, but from the side, they've actually got just they're just a little bit shorter. So that's one little tidbit. So I have a head here, which is one of the molds. You can see that it kind of doesn't really line up. And getting this was just a lot of like trial and error, getting that perfect fit. Or you can sculpt away at it if it doesn't fit properly. But I don't really care about that gap, because you're not going to see it. You're not going to see it when the model's done. And if you do, you're looking way too close to the model, and you know, it's not competition. It's not a competition, guys, calm down. This glue's fine when you're, you know, just doing small stuff. But it does tend to go shitty after a small amount of time, I've noticed. So that's one arm. And grabbing the unarmed hand, which has really, really gross over... Look at that. How bad does that look? way you should clean your models before you start working with them. I'm in a rush. Doesn't really matter. Now, one of the coolest things with super glue is getting it on your fingers and getting them stuck together. It's definitely something I recommend. Alright, so next we're going to do the head. Now I'm going to kind of like do a pretty large wallop on the top, like a bit of a bobble, so it sits within the whole spot. This is really good English. If you could see it, there's like, it's kind of like a water drop on a leaf. So it sort of sits over the top. I'm going to put that on there, and he's done. So that's the head done. And you can see already that the scale of Warhammer compared to these dudes is kind of crazy. And once you add that backpack as well, it does add a bit of girth. Just a tiny bit of girth to the models, which is what you want. You want them to be a little girthy. Otherwise, you know, they won't match the rest of the stuff. So let's quickly add the backpack, which is literally, bloop, same kind of situation. And this is very not clean. Quickly do this. And quickly slap that on the back like that. And you've got yourself a Kriegsmen. It's pretty bare bones. And we still have to do the shoulder pads, so there's actual armor on those shoulder pads. But he's a Kriegsmen, right? Right? Just quickly base him. Now, I like to add mud to these guys, so even if that, like, looks a bit stupid, there's going to be a layer of mud to build it up. So he should look fine, I hope. Let's put him over here. Let's work on the next one. So there we go. They've got an aiming Deathkorps. Again, that gun, totally up to you whether or not you want to keep it as this, or you want to chop and change. So you could chop it up or add magazines and stuff underneath. Totally up to you. You could add like sights and different barrels, and at that point you might as well be 3D printing the arms instead, because that's a lot of chopping and changing. I have seen some really good kit bashes where people do that kind of stuff, but it's a little too finesse for me, especially considering I have the ability to 3D print the whole gun and arms. I'd rather just keep it like this. I like the look of it. Completely up to you. This is going to be the one that probably doesn't work. And I don't know if I've tested this. Oh, I have. Okay. I had to have a quick look to see if I'd done this before, and I have. It does look a little weird. So forgive me if you don't like the look of this one. But I'm going to be using the 3D printed parts that I designed. And he's going to be holding a gun down by his side. And I'll explain why I'm doing different ones here. And the benefits and non-benefits of these guys. So naturally, I've scaled these to about the same size as 40K's ones. So it's in a heroic scale. Put that, that shovel over his shoulder. You can see he's already looking a bit off. This is my own opinion. I think he looks a tiny bit off, like his shoulders are just a bit too wide for his own good. Like if you look at his brother over here, his shoulders are like in and like prim and proper, but I think this is kind of like the eye of the beholder situation. I'm using heroic scale with true scale. It's going to conflict, but this is probably going to look more correct in the long term. Like if I was to put him next to actual guys, like this is a Imperial Guardsman that's been converted. If I was to put him next to them, his arms will look more correct than old Skinny McGee here. This will just look like a completely different model, and it does. So this is the benefits and burdens of kit bashing with different kind of kits. My personal opinion, I don't care. I actually really like the way they look. I just like having lots and lots on the battlefield. He's like, once you got that backpack on, it does kind of like fill in a lot of the void. And I will glue him to the base. There we go. We've got three different dudes here. They've all got their own little quirks. One of them is technically done. The other two, they need a little bit more work, a little bit more love. So what I mean by that is you can see with this guy right here, this Imperial Guardsman, got this shoulder pads, right? Really nice, because they're built in. I didn't have to sculpt them, they're done. You can see with this guy here, these shoulder pads are not built in. I had to sculpt these. They still look good, but you know, they're a little bit more work. So we need to sculpt shoulder pads onto these guys, because they don't have them. They're not there. They've got little tassels, which are cool if you want that on your dudes. It could look pretty cool, actually, to be honest. But I don't want that, because these guys aren't fancy. These are my everyday... The skinnier they are, the shitter they are. And in my rules, that's my law. It's the skinnier they are, the less combat effective they are, because they're brand new. And they're just on the front line, and they're just expendable. This guy, obviously... A little different, because, you know, he's had some pretty hardcore arm days. We'll go with that. Alright, so what we're going to do is go into my 400-year-old Epoxy Sculpt. Highly recommend this. Don't recommend this huge a tub. It's way too big. Probably, like, half this would be good. So I've opened this up. I've already like kind of got this out, because this stuff sticks really bad to the inside of the walls once you get to the bottom. I had to scrape that out with my nails. So I've gone and bagged it, and I really don't need a lot of this. Now this is just like a kind of like a glad wrap food bag, and you can see right there I've grabbed maybe like a pinch. This is probably too much. I'm gonna try and use that. Now that was part That was actually part B. I thought it was part A. Now this is part A, so you got a two-part sculpt here. And we'll grab the same amount for the other side, and we really need to make sure it's the same amount. I've just kind of like pinched a little bit and see. It's pretty good. I like that, that's enough. They're basically the same size. So we're gonna mix those two together, and then we're going to sculpt on shoulder pads. All right, so here we go. You can see there, that's nice and done. And it's, again, it's probably too much, but what I wanna do is sort of make it into a bit of a snake. Like so. Yeah, that doesn't even matter. Snake it, and then sort of grab a piece off. I'm trying to remember how much I'll need. This is really, because I've done so many of them. Probably like that. And then get another size. Think about having nails. About the same size there. So that's two little drops. Like I've made way too much. If this is actually the size that I need. In total I need four drops. But I'll show you what you can do with the excess if you have this set up. This is a little insider knowledge. I don't know if it is excess yet, so let's just plop this on the shoulder like this and hope it sticks. That's one and two and done. Really bad shoulder pads. No. And I'm gonna use my knife, even though I had that sculptor the tools next to me. And all I'm going to do is kind of flatten it out over the shoulder pad. Over the shoulder, so it looks like a shoulder pad. And again, this is just a trial and error with experience. You'll be able to do this. Really not crazy hard. Just flattening it out. And because it's a ball, it's already got the sort of the right shape. To get the bottom, I'm just going to flatten it out a bit. Like that. And then I want it to sort of have a layer, so like this. I haven't done this with all my dudes, but have it so there's actually two shoulder pads in there, sort of thing. I'm gonna clip it down. Am I doing this close enough? Clip it down like that. And then like this. See, that kind of looks cool. Same story here, so cover that bit there. So you can see, he's got his shoulder pads now, and he's happy. He's a happy Kriegsman right there. Now the other one, do the exact same thing. There we go. So we've got the shoulder pads nice and done, and they will have to sit for a while. You can, if you want to, add like tiny little rivets in there. I wanted to. This is weird sculpting with another guy, but you can like add tiny little rivet holes like that using someone else's gun. That works pretty nicely. Why not, right? Go. Like that. You see those tiny little dots, they will add up quite a lot in the end. Because, you know, you'll be using your paints and it'll work. Now I need to do this one. Oh wait! It's already done. That's the benefit of this. That's it. That's the only benefit of using these arms. No, it's pretty cool because, you know, they're done and you can... This is a crumped up arm. This would be quite difficult to sculpt that shoulder armor in there. So he's pretty good. He's pretty done. And we're pretty much done, honestly. We're left with this, which I'm going to show you what to do with. Now, you need this. You need these. This is the best part about having excess sculpty, whatever it is you're using. You can use your excess and make more things with it. So instead of just throwing it away or making some really stupid sculpture, you can... Or, this is going to be a tight squeeze, you might be able to get two helmets out of this. So, roll it up like this. Get it in there. And kind of like really squish it in there. Now I'm actually going to need a sculpting tool for this. And then you push it in like that. And really ram it in there. You want it to reach all the edges that are inside there. And when that's all dried up, it'll be a happy little helmet. And the way I've designed it is, it's got this little piece here, so I push on that and it comes out. With everything here, I'll do my best to round up links and leave them in the description below. But you can see these are pretty good. They kind of do the job. They're a lot of work. Sort of. If you're happy with making molds, then this is great. If you want to do 3D printed parts, then you can go ahead and do that and attach them to this anyway. That could be a 3D printed head. Ignore that. So you can see there's a lot of options here. And you know, you end up with way too much stuff. You can see all this. I've just gone vertical mode. These are all ignore him. These are all kitbashed. Every single one of these dudes is kitbashed. Pull them out. And they just keep going, honestly. And the horses too. If you're one to collect your kits, you know, stuff that you like to build up over time, it's super easy, it's super fun. So I want to do a lot more kitbashing in the future, and I intend to. I'm going to be going into some Age of Sigmar stuff. I've got some more of these guys that I'm working on. I'm just working on these guys all the time. You can see how long that took to make the three. If you aren't talking the whole time, you can make this in lickety split. So here we have the final three models that we made. You can see each one is unique in its own little way. Got this guy who has his 3D printed parts. The middle one and this one over here are almost the same way. We made the head and the backpacks by getting molds of actual parts. So there's a little mold here. And then we did the same with the heads. With the shoulder pads, however, we did manually sculpt those and they came out really well. As opposed to this guy, which still came out well. But, you know, it's all 3D printed, which is, it's completely up to you whether or not you like the 3D printedness. I think it's good to have all three options. You can just use kits, you can use all this kind of, it's just awesome. Honestly, I think if you can make things and you enjoy it, then Don't let anyone stop you, honestly. I've really been loving kitbashing, so I'm kind of going a bit silly with it, in all honesty. I plan to make more videos where I'm talking directly to people, like right now, and I'm working on stuff at the same time. So that's that. That's how they came out. Pretty good. I'm quite happy with it. This new setup with the 3D character, let me know what you think of it. It has its ups and its downs, and I'm hoping to have more ups more than downs, because we want to have, you know, being able to talk to people and have character interactions and stuff during streams. So while I'm playing a game or talking to people, or even while I'm doing these little sculpty things, you can actually interact with me and make me do some crazy stuff that I couldn't do in person. Or on camera, that is. So if you're interested in this kind of stuff, head over to Twitch in the link in the description below, and I'll catch you in one of the streams, or you'll catch me, to be more precise. Huge thanks to my patrons over on Patreon for supporting me. It's been a long time since I made a video. A huge long time, and you guys have just been supporting me all the way through, and I can't thank you guys enough, honestly. It means a ton. It really does. I hope I've been able to deliver. I've been making models on the side while I've been busy. If you aren't aware and you're still watching this far in, huge thank you. I had a baby daughter in November last year, so 2021. So I've kind of had a big hiatus, and I wouldn't say this is my huge welcome back to YouTube kind of thing, but it's my big huge welcome back to YouTube thing. So hopefully you guys see me more around, and yeah, we'll have some more crazy Twitch stuff coming in the future. Huge thanks, as always. Stay awesome, and I'll catch you in the next one. See you guys.